Got a letter the other day from a kid named Jimmy, just 10 years old. He wrote, "Dear Mike, have you ever been in jail before?" Can you believe that? 10-year-old kid asking me a question like that. Well, Jimmy, the answer is no. But I have thought on more than one occasion how interesting it might be to be on the lam. You know, a fugitive from the authorities, out there alone, running for my freedom, being chased perhaps by a bunch of volunteers with their bloodhounds and hot in pursuit, a sheriff. You're C.B. Wiley?
C.B. Wiley.
Are you sheriff?
Constable.
As a constable, you are a guy who from time to time could find himself in pursuit of a convict?
Yes, sir. We catch them.
What is this group called, actually?
This is the Van Zandt County Bloodhound Team. It's comprised of about 40 people, volunteers.
Mm-hmm.
Both handlers and hounds learn the art of tracking people on this 200-acre game ranch in East Texas, where there's plenty of room for the dogs to follow their legendary noses.
Wow, their faces, they seem to have too much skin.
This is the nature of the bloodhound. The scent comes off the ground, the ears kind of stir it up, and it comes up and falls into the pores and mixes with the sweat glands, and
really?
As a result, you get smell.
Is there a bloodhound here who's sort of the top dog, so to speak?
It had to be Tucker right here. He's the top dog in the kennel.
Tucker, how are you, big boy? Look at you.
Look at his ears. That tells you his battle scars.
Holy cow. So you're saying his ears are going to pick up my smell?
Yes, sir.
My smell is going to get absorbed into this fabulous, fabulous face, and then it's going to be on me.
We have to worry about the wind and the scent, the temperature, and all when we're working with dogs.
Now, bloodhounds, I would assume, not just used for chasing down the nefarious ne'er-do-wells, miscreants, and whatnot, but really anyone.
We go after lost children and missing persons, and we've chased some on wheelchairs and the rest homes.
Just so I heard you right, you got a team of bloodhounds chasing down somebody in a wheelchair, AWOL from a rest home?
There's lots of Alzheimer's patients that are in the rest homes that
sure.
just wander off.
Sure.
And many of them are mobile with their wheelchairs.
The heck of a thing. All right, so I got a 10-minute head start. This is the shirt I've been wearing all day. I'll leave this somewhere down
just
the line.
Anywhere you want to leave it.
And Tucker's slobbered all over me. I guess that's a sign of affection.
That there is going to be a souvenir you can take with you.
My sense of smell's not that great. It smells like regular old spit, Tucker. You really do look like every sheriff I've seen in a lot of movies. What's CB stand for?
Could be.
Can you say what we have here is a failure to communicate?
Not necessarily.
Good enough. I had to ask. All right, so I'm going to take off. You're going to follow me in 10 minutes, and we'll see if you can find me before the sun goes down.
Get after it.
You know what I need? I need
get
a camera, too. Ryan, let me have this to you. Just to heighten the sense of what's going on here, I'll be shooting myself on this thing as I run. So people can see the sense of true terror in my face. Pretty terrifying, don't you think?
Mm-hmm.
It was rhetorical. You're a good-looking constable.
Yeah,
I want you. Strother Martin's got nothing on you. All right, then. I'd love to chat, but I'm a fugitive. On the lam. Make a hole, Ryan. I'm coming at you. I'm running. I did a bad thing and I'm running. 10 minutes! Oh crap.
What's the problem? I don't know where I am. I should just go in that house. That would confuse me. Let's leave this right here. Uh-oh. Dogs. I'm going up this road here.
See where it takes me.
How do I look on the lam? Ooh. It's terrible. I'm tired already.
As if I'm not in trouble enough, Dave has recruited his son, Cash Wiley, to join his posse.
They're ready to go. They're ready to run. They're ready to do their thing. So, hit it, then. Find him, find him, find him, find him, find him, find him.
CB's been training bloodhounds for over 35 years. He currently has 15 working hounds and works with 30 to 40 volunteer handlers.
There are fences. Fences everywhere. Okay. And apparently animals on the other side of them, so that's a bad sign. That's a... Being on the run is exhausting.
Now, y'all, look for tracks. Look for tracks.
Dog when you're right, it's got a hot nose. Good.
Bloodhounds are a 1,500-year-old breed, first used by nobility to track deer, wild boar, and later man.
Watch your legs.
That would be me.
And running through water does not always mean that you're not going to get found.
What would I do if I were Bear Grylls? I'd say, My only chance is to get out of the open. I've got to somehow find the woods, the cover of the trees, and then fashion a lean-to, perhaps, from matchsticks. So, do you think I should hide in a... in this old little shed here? Huh. What if I got on top? I could potentially be up here and lie flat. Oh, man, I know they'd see me, though. Yeah, I hear him.
That dog got a trail yonder right now.
They say a hound's nose is 3 million times more sensitive than a human's, and they can follow a trail up to 130 miles. Too far for this fugitive.
I could hide in a duck blind, I guess, but it just seems pointless. Sun's going down, moon's coming out. I know they're gonna find me, but at least I can see him coming from here. I should be able to.
Oh, yeah, maybe a tree. I could almost climb that.
Oh, you know what? Maybe I can.
Okay.
All right, then. Now we're talking. All right, so I'm up a tree. I don't think it's going to do any good. But I got up here.
And I feel proud of that.
They should be coming that way. Of course, what they could have done is just gone back to the house, and they're all having a beer now laughing. That wouldn't be funny.
Watch the dog.
CB tells me back in the early 1900s, a legendary bloodhound named Nick Carter tracked down over 650 criminals. One trail Nick followed was over 100 hours old. Hopefully none of CB's dogs are as good as Nick.
It's been 24 minutes since I left. If they waited for 10, that means they've been coming after me for nearly 15. They're probably going half the speed I was going, which means they should be here in 5. I did that in my head.
Watch your dog's nose. He's on a hot trail or not.
I'm up a tree.
Is that where he's at? Apparently he spent some time in there because they went there.
Often called a nose with a dog attached, the bloodhound is so accurate in its tracking that the trailing results are admissible evidence in a court of law.
Hear him? I can hear him, which means they can smell me.
You can tell when you got a good hot dog, his nose to the ground, running. Where would a convict be if he was hiding around here? Hunt him up, and lots of encouragement. Just look everywhere that you possibly can. Always be looking up in the trees.
Uh-oh.
Watch your dog's nose.
And we don't know how dangerous this individual is, so you want to borrow my handcuff?
I am so scared.
Trust your dog. Let him go. Guess what? I just found two dogs that made a positive find. They're circling a tree right now. Convict! Do you want to come down out of the tree peacefully? Or do you want us to remove you?
I'm a branch. I'm a branch covered with moss.
Come down or we're gonna shoot you out of the tree, one of the two.
That seems extreme, Cash.
I think they found me.
Well, you got me.
No doubt about it.
You got me.
I've never really had a chance, man. There's a guy on horseback, there are guys in ATVs, there's six dogs.
Voila.
There's Barsky. Unbelievable. Who wants my camera?
Chunk it, I'll catch it, I promise.
It's coming right toward you. One, two, three.
Oh. I caught it.
I caught it. After promising everything.
I promised. I caught it. We're still filming.
That's exciting. Where's the big cheese? CB. Stands for could be. You guys are basically on standby then? 24/7.
We go free anywhere. The reward's in your heart when you do that.